Greetings. Black Light one more time. I lost 24/7. Prime time. God Vision. Welcome to the God Zone. We got to get quickly to this. The trickery of the Caucasian. So, we're talking about the Shrine of the Black Madonna today. We're going to tie that in with how did the White House get to be called the White House. And if you notice that the trials are talking about the Constitution, but then they're avoiding the fact that the Federal Reserve paid off Congress and loaning money to Congress to start wars, and the Catholic Church, the Vatican, took over the identity of Jesus, but in the basement they got the real Jesus. All trickery. But they're hiding all this in plain sight. Let's read what this says behind us before we get into it. And, you know, as we go, you'll understand more clearly. This says right here, the most sacred icon of the Catholic Church are the Black Madonna and Christ Child, which are found in Europe's most venerated shrines and cathedrals each year. Hundreds of thousands of European pilgrims ritually can't make out this word right here. Humble themselves before the image of Black Mary and her child Jesus at Black Madonna sites throughout France, Germany, Spain, Italy, Belgium, Portugal, and other cathedrals and countries. Other countries. And you notice, note that in Mecca, the Kaaba, inside of the Kaaba is a black stone representing the black man. So let's get further into it before time goes by.
Thank you.
As you see, there's all kinds of portraits, paintings, and statues of the shrine of the Black Madonna, Black Mother, Black Child. You see what I'm saying? So why did they change the image of Jesus, whose real name is Esau? This is the image that they want you to see. Hollywood, you know, puts this image out. There are paintings of Jesus being a Caucasian man. These are Romans who are crucifying him. Now, the Catholic Pope is over there in Rome in a nation called Vatican. The Jews allowed Jesus, according to the Bible, to be crucified. And this is what all the majority of the world, this is the image of Jesus, supposed to be God, the Son of God.
For thousands of years, the holy lands of the Middle East have run with blood. Here, the scars of battle fought between three of the great religions of the world are etched into the earth. But the deepest wound was made by a war between Christian and Muslim, begun at the close of the 11th century and fought for 200 years. At stake, a tiny strip of land just a few hundred miles long, but with the greatest prize. Jerusalem.
The Crusades are still happening right now. The Crusades are still happening, but they got white Arabs portraying the Islam, the religion of Islam, when in fact they're a minority. Then they got white Romans portraying the Crusades. All this goes back to Egypt or Kemet, the Ethiopians. So it's coming together where you might can see what's really happening in the White House, because they're on the brink of war with Iran.
Today, the Bulletin of the Atomic Scientists moves the hands of the doomsday clock. It is 100 seconds to midnight. Today, the Bulletin of the Atomic Scientists moves the hands of the doomsday clock. It is 100 seconds to midnight.
See, whether or not you realize it or not, the new world order is crumbling. The charade is up. Too many people are getting wise to this stage cover-up in the White House. The Federal Reserve. Check it out.
The flag of Washington's District of Columbia has three red stars, one for each city-state in the three-city empire. This corporate empire of three city-states controls the world economically through London's inner city, militarily through the District of Columbia, and spiritually through the Vatican. The Constitution for the District of Columbia operates under a tyrannical Roman law known as Lex Fori, which bears no resemblance to the U.S. Constitution.
See, they done made a business out of religion. They done made a business out of culture, a business out of nature. And their business is you got to go to them for everything. And they done brainwashed people into thinking that they are poor and they are sinners. You know, evil and wicked. And they brainwash people into thinking that only Jesus could save them, or the White House can save them. The president can save them. Spiritual, military, USA military, spiritually, Vatican, economic, London, London. We've been breaking it down to you, hoping that you could get it. Why they don't talk about that in Congress, about the Federal Reserve? Why don't young Pharaoh, why don't Sinetta, Seti, all them polite, they don't talk about that. Steve Coakley used to talk about it. We're going to talk about it some more next video. Tricknoledgy in the White House. The Illuminati pulling the strings. That's the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers. Sugar, sugar, salt, and salt. If you ain't digging on this, it ain't my fault. Let's go.